What's going on, guys? It is Bernardo, and you just saw a quick unboxing on Lenovo's ThinkPad X13 Generation 4 laptop. So what comes inside the box? We have our safety information guide right here. Awesome. We have our ThinkPad X13 Generation 4 setup guide. Pretty cool. We have our power cable. And we have our power adapter, which is actually a Type-C connection, 65 watts. Cool. I'm going to take the power cable and the power adapter and hook them up. Bam. Awesome. So let's put this stuff to the side. And then last but not least, we have the beautiful ThinkPad X13 Generation 4 laptop weighing around 2.6 pounds with a thickness of 0.74 inches. This guy is a super lightweight. Look how I'm just like handling it. It's like super easy, very light. Wow. Now, if you have the laptop facing you to the point that you are able to open it up like this, on your right hand side, we have one 3.2 USB port and we have our HDMI port. On the left hand side, we have our smart card reader, which is optional, a headphone / microphone combo jack, one 3.2 USB always on charging, and then we have two Thunderbolt 4 ports. And then one of them you could actually use for your power adapter. All right, so we just went over some of the ports and features on the ThinkPad X13 Generation 4 laptop. Let's take the power cable and plug it in. Again, you have two Thunderbolt 4 ports. You could use either one. You are able to use the notch right here, which is housing the webcam and the mics. We're going to go over that pretty soon. And just use one finger. I'm going to hold it down just to open up that beautiful 13.3 display, which we are going to talk about it pretty soon. Don't worry about that. How awesome is that? Now, the power button is located right here on top of the keyboard, and the power button is actually integrated with the fingerprint scanner. So let's power this guy on. Like I said earlier, the fingerprint scanner is actually integrated within the power button right here. So let's take advantage of it and use it. Let's log in. All right, so let's talk about the trackpad on the ThinkPad X13 Generation 4 laptop. Off the bat, using it was okay, but when I took it out the box and I booted it up and I was using it, the trackpad actually froze on me. I wasn't able to right-click on anything, meaning I wasn't able to right-click on a folder or on the desktop to get the submenu. It was a really weird issue with it. I don't think it was a laptop problem. I think it was more of a Windows 11 problem. But once I did the reboot, that fixed the problem. I did find myself using a USB mouse half the time. Again, I love using USB mouse when I'm doing, you know, my work on a laptop. The trackpad is like the last resort. If you want to know the measurement of the trackpad, it is around 4.53 inches. For the keyboard on the ThinkPad X13 Gen 4, the keyboard works. I mean, it didn't have any issues at all. It is a ThinkPad keyboard, which is super responsive. You are able to type with no problem. In the middle of the keyboard, you have the signature track point right here, as well as within the trackpad, we have the integration of the left and right click buttons right there, and you could just use with the track point anytime. If you want to know the distance between each key on the keyboard, it is around 0.12 inches. The keyboard is backlit, so right now it is turned off. If you hold the function key in the space bar, that turns it on the first level. If you hit it again, that is the second level, and if you hit it one more time, it turns it off. Now, for speakers on the ThinkPad X13 Generation 4 are located right here on your right and left-hand side on top of the keyboard. Now, for the loudness of the speakers, the room was around 53.7 decibels. I raised the laptop to 50%, and that bumped it up to 81.3 decibels, which was an increase of 27.6 decibels. When I raised the laptop to 100%, it bumped it up to 91.1 decibels, giving it an additional bump of 9.8 decibels. So a total of 37.4 decibels of the loudness that I got on these speakers. Now for the display, it is rocking a beautiful 13.3 IPS touchscreen display Like, I'm not really a big fan with touchscreens because of the smudge, all that dirty fingerprints on the screen, so I hardly touched it, but you are able to take advantage of the touchscreen. The resolution on this particular laptop is around 1920 by 1200. The brightness level right now, I think this is the highest, and this is the lowest that you could go, and this is the highest, and this is the lowest. And one more time, let's go to the highest. Now, off the bat, when I took it out the box and I was playing around with the brightness was not working at all. Well, the way that we're doing it right now, it wasn't working, right? I kept on pressing to lower the brightness and it wasn't doing it until I actually plugged in the power cable. Then it started working, which is really strange. If you want to know, the nit level is around 300 on this particular laptop. The refresh rate on the display is around 60 hertz. At the top of the beautiful display, you have this notch, which is actually housing the webcam. Now, the webcam is around 2.1 megapixels. For video, you're able to capture 1080p with 30 frames per second, basically making the webcam a full HD. Right next to the webcam, you have your dual mics. Now, I did take some raw footage on the webcam and the built-in mic, so let's take a look at that.
All right, so we are recording with the built-in webcam on the ThinkPad X13 Generation 4 laptop. Like I said before, the webcam is a 2.1 megapixel. For video, you get a full HD webcam, 1080p, with 30 frames per second. As you saw before in the B-roll, I was setting everything up using OBS Studio. This is how it sounds. This is how it looks without any lights. If I do turn some of the lights, it kind of, you know, adjusts itself pretty well. It's not that bad. Again, it has dual microphones on this system, so I'm using everything built in. So hopefully it sounds and looks good during post.
All right, so we just finished talking about the trackpad, keyboard, and the display on the ThinkPad X13 Generation 4 laptop. Let's talk about the performance. So I'm going to hold Control, Shift, and hit Escape. Fancy way to bring up the task manager. Let's expand the task manager up a little bit. Let's go into performance. Within the CPU, let's right-click on it, change the graph to logical processor. Now, this laptop has a 13th Gen Intel Core i7-1365U processor with a base speed of 1.80 gigahertz, one socket, 10 cores, 12 logical processors. Wow, it is a beast. Small little guy, but it is super strong. From memory, it has 16 gigs. It comes with a solid state drive, which is around 500 gigs. And for your GPU, you have the Intel Iris Xe graphics card. Now, with the following specifications, I was able to do Photoshop. I was able to do DaVinci, Audition, Premiere. But there were times that Premiere or Photoshop crashed on me on this machine. It is not a machine to do some heavy editing. Quick editing, small little files. Yes, this is the type of machine I would definitely travel with, but my everyday editing machine to do 4K rendering or long format videos, definitely I could not do this on this machine. When I was doing color correction using DaVinci, it was a little slow because it's using the Intel Iris Xe graphics card to do some of the modifications. For heating, I got heating between 98 to 104 Fahrenheit. It does have a vent at the back of the laptop, and the vent actually extends to between the keyboard and the display, where all that heat actually hits the display because of the way that the vent on the back is designed. For gaming, I was actually able to game with this laptop. It's not the best gaming laptop in the world, but I was able to actually play Doom on it. The graphics is not that bad to me. It's not the best in the world. The colors on the display is great, but the performance, again, I kind of recommend hooking it up with power. But regardless if you have the power hooked up, it still will lag on you. All right, so we just went over some of the specification, and I also talked about the performance on the ThinkPad X13 Generation 4. Let's talk about the battery, because laptops, battery, it just makes sense. So let's close this up. Let's open up Chrome. And I like to use PC Mark 10 when I do my battery tests. And the first one was the modern office battery life. And I got 2 hours. I was like, wait a minute, 2 hours and 11 minutes? That's just too low. That's really low. So I ran it again and I got a better timing, which was around 6 hours and 1 minute, which is really good. On my third test, I did video and that took around 5 hours and 4 minutes, just playing nonstop video until the battery died out. And then last but not least, I did gaming, which was around 2 hours and 19 minutes on the battery, just playing video games. I think overall, using the laptop, I had maybe between 5 to 6 hours, and it all depends on how you use the laptop. But that's not that bad, around 5 to 6 hours. And if you tweak the settings, like lower down the display, and it really depends on what you're doing, you can actually get between 7 to 8 hours of battery life on this particular laptop. All right, so before we conclude our review slash unboxing on the ThinkPad X13 Generation 4 laptop, I did forget to mention that it does come with a privacy guard for those individuals that like that. I like that myself. It's pretty smooth to open and close. Now, for external monitors, you are able to hook up 3 of them. An HDMI, and then you got the 2 Thunderbolt 4. I don't recommend doing 3 because you do need to have 1 power supply to power everything on. So technically, you could just have 2, 1 Type-C, 1 HDMI. Because I did not have a native monitor with a Type-C connection, I actually had to use a Type-C adapter with an HDMI. That's how I used that Type-C port to actually display something on a monitor. Now for pricing, starting price is around $910, and the highest point is around $1060. It all depends on how you get it configured with the hard drive, memory, and also the display, because it comes with different display flavors. Pretty easy to upgrade. You just put it flat down on the backside. There's a bunch of screws that you're able to unscrew, unscrew that. Real smooth and easy, remove the back part of it, because if not, you're able to break a couple of pieces. And then you got an overview of all the parts that you're able to kind of replace by yourself. Overall experience on this machine using Photoshop and Premiere, DaVinci, again, it's a little slow for me, but it is a great laptop for those individuals that are working from home. This is a laptop to check Outlook, Word documents, PowerPoint documents, go online, you know, watch some movies on Netflix, or just chill with YouTube flicks like I was. I mean, the color on the display is great. When I was watching content within YouTube, it's great. Beautiful colors. I just don't see this laptop being a graphic designer or a videographer laptop. This is more of a work from home or travel to do work, right? No video editing and no photo editing. If you need to do that, you're able to do it, but just don't expect the best performance at all on this laptop. The size of it, it's great, super light, 2.6 pounds. I'm loving the size, like, come on, that's great. Super light to carry, easy to put in a bag and then carry anywhere. The only thing I do not like about the laptop is the lack of ports. It is missing one of the ports that I like to use a lot, which would be the SD card, because again, my video cameras have an SD card. I just like to slap it inside one of my laptops and just grab my videos. Overall, it does have a good amount of ports. 2 USBs, Type-C, HDMI, it has those ports, but for me, it's lacking that one additional port that I need, and that's the SD card slot. Laptop is great for those individuals that are home working, doing Outlook, Zoom meetings, team meetings. This is the laptop that you should get. Overall, hopefully you guys enjoyed this video, and I catch you guys on the next one. Peace out.